What are the risks and opportunities facing global funds and their investors as the UK prepares to exit the European Union? At Chatham House's recent Spring Capital Markets Conference, that topped the agenda of a panel discussion that ICI Global Managing Director Dan Waters moderated. And afterwards, he shared with me these key takeaways.
We focus, as you would have expected, on delegation for quite a lot of the discussion. That's one of the ICI Global members' most important priorities in the Brexit debate. We heard some encouraging things, I think, from Robert Ophel, who, the chairman of the AMF in Paris, who basically said, we're not trying to undermine the global delegation model. I think the discussion there is really something more around substance. The demonstration of the control of the delegation. That's something that I think our members are quite comfortable with, because of course our members have substantial presences in many jurisdictions in the EU. So I think it was somewhat comforting to hear that kind of discussion going on. That was a big issue. Also a lot of discussion of the CMU.
Indeed, there was a lot of discussion of how can we make this something more, well, let's go back to the word substantive.
Yeah, and that's been a concern all along. And I think there was a bit of cynicism, I would even say, expressed about why the CMU was launched, but we're kind of beyond that now, and we're really looking for some outcomes. We expressed our disappointment about the recent proposal by the Commission in respect of cross-border barriers to distribution of UCITS, and we were hoping for something a bit more energetic to solve some of the barriers to the single market in UCITS. And I think there's some support for that on what the panel was hearing as well. So, you know, that's the beginning of that process, and we'll see where that goes from here.
Dan, we can't close out this conversation without also talking about the discussion about the free trade agreement.
So that's something that our members are very keen to see, namely that financial services should be included in the scope of the free trade agreement. It's very interesting, in references made to the statements by the French Minister of Finance, who's been quite categorically saying it's not possible. But interestingly, the draft guidelines from the Council mention services. So I think the door is open. And I do think, and I certainly took from some of the things that were said in the discussion today, that reasonable people trying to find a solution ought to be able to find some middle ground there. Where financial services could be included. We all know it's not going to be the single market. And I think everybody accepts, if you don't accept the four freedoms, you don't get the single market. And it's not, the impression is that the UK government's not looking for the Norway solution, but they're looking for more than Canada. And certainly our members, from our perspective, we want to keep servicing of our funds and our investors' needs paramount, so that the least disruption is what we're looking for. And we know that we're not going to have the same world that we have now, but we'd like to have one that works for our investors. So I took some hope away from that.